Metzger back with another video for you guys. And back, I got my baby girl. So we're gonna try and do video real quick before she wakes up and wants to eat real fast. So this video, what I'm gonna talk about in this Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes video, is the difference, or how should I say this? You know, you got Galactic War and you got Squad Arena, right? Well, here is what I found out to be kind of the hiccup between the two, because you want to, so as far as I know, and they may have changed this recently, but the higher your power in Squad Arena, the higher your, let's say, your power is on your last win is, you know, going to be, you know, how badly impacted your Galactic War is. So what I noticed is once I started gaining more power, higher power in the Squad Arena, my Galactic War started becoming crazy insane. I don't know about you guys, but like I would be like level 59 and I would start off with level 70s, fully, you know, geared out. It just was ridiculous. Anyway, so what I've done is on my way through playing this game and trying to balance out the two. Now, to be honest, Galactic War seems to have the better benefit. Now, you know, as you can see here, I was ranked 24 yesterday. Now, it's with some pretty decent, you know, goodies there. But you got to think here, like, okay, am I just going to go all out in Arena and go for those awards and then struggle in Galactic War? You know, it's really up to you. I'm not in a position to get first place. I'm only level, what, 67? 67 or so? So, you know, no, I'm not in a position to be in the first place bracket. So I don't even want to... I decided to really not even increase my power. So what I've done, though, is... what I've done is... as you can see, we'll just choose one here. So what I've done is I've taken four characters instead of five. I've taken my highest powered four characters, which would be Qui-Gon, GS, Sidious, and Luminara currently. And just put in somebody, a fifth slot that has a low power. As you can see, Barriss here, you know, Barriss's power is only 2725 at level 48. But what I've found is I can maintain like a top 20, top 25, top 15 sometimes ranking in my server with this team just running with somebody lower level. And I've used different people as I've been leveling them up. You know, I ran, you know, Poe Dameron for a little bit, but he seems pretty weak at 3-star, so I took him off even with a lower power. You know, I've ran Count Dooku and Akbar and Han. I was running Han for a little bit, and some of these other guys. But, you know, I haven't tried climbing the rankings. I'm sure I could go higher if I just apply, you know, maybe Phasma or JC. But then my power is so high, you know, as you can see with my power level being 25K with those guys. You know, with having Barriss... at the level she's at, this kind of allows me to get a pretty solid Galactic War to where I've been completing Galactic War every day. Every single day I've been completing it, running with this team in Arena. I haven't had super duper hard Galactic Wars, and I'm still ranking, you know, top 15 through top 25. As you saw earlier, I was number 24, and you know, there's some pretty tough teams in here. Like, you can see these teams here, you know, like, I could probably beat you know, all of these teams with the team I have, even with Barris being such a low character. And as you can see, like, you go to my Galactic War here, you know, I got 5,400 Galactic Wars nuggets because I complete them every time, because I'm trying to get at that balance. You know, I'd say, like, once I hit 70 and I have five characters, at least 70, I don't even know if I'll still do it yet, try and go for the squad arena, because, you know, when you are going through this Galactic War, the goodies you get out of there seem to be a lot better for me anyway, because I'm getting way more gold. Gold is ridiculous when you get to this level. You need gold for everything. And ability mats. You get ability mats and training droids, which are nice. To be honest, I would rather complete Galactic War every day than, you know, be in the top 10, which I can't do. I mean, I'm sure if I brought my squad power on my arena as high as I can, my Galactic War would probably be ridiculous. I probably wouldn't even make it through halfway through, which is retarded. But, you know, whatever. But let me show you. So, even with Barris off, you know, I'll probably, let's go for, let's see here. Yeah, let's start off with this team. So, I should be able to beat this team with this team. Because, you know, Barris, she hits like shit, but she's got decent health and she's got a nice heal. And it heals through all the Sidiouses because everybody runs Sidious. So let's see if I can win this. I don't always win, but I do pretty well usually. So we're going to attempt Sidious here. And that's the one problem that you'll notice is when you have these call and assist characters and Barris, you know, her assist is just, it's horror bad. Yeah, like how unlucky am I to get Barris on a call and assist twice? I mean, that's just ridiculous. I can try and kill Sidious here, but I got their whole team coming up, so I'm just going to heal. So they're going to heal anyway. I just don't want to get any deaths because Sidious will heal anyway. Okay. Oh my god, deflected. That would have been offensive up. Lumi's down, that's not good. Let's see if I can get some turn meter. So this is not looking too good for me. Okay, looking better. If I can get Lumi dead here, oh no, I'll feel better, but... There we go. We got some offense up. Okay. Things are starting to look pretty good here. Oh, and then he had to do that. Chewie, you are so annoying. We good. We got this. And boom. There it is. As you can see, we got a victory. You know, not too bad. Boom. 33. You know, and that was a full team of, as you can see, all purple, you know, pretty tough competition, you know, for my ranking anyway. So right there, and then we'll be able to go into Galactic War, and I'm actually working on Phasma at the moment, and then I'm gonna go Pogonius. So yeah, so far it looks like an easy start for me. And just so you guys can kind of see my roster and what I'm working with here. So my plan is once Lumi GS, Qui-Gon and Sidious, they're pretty much geared pretty well, almost done. I'm gonna get Phasma next, and then working on JC, Mace Windu, and then once I have those two, I'm gonna get Barriss. I'm gonna take Barriss up, all the way up, and then I'm gonna try and get Yoda at 7 for the squad arena. You know, and on the side, I'll say, as you can see, I have Leia at 6-star. But on the side, I am working on a Rebel team. As you can see, I have Han, Leia, HRS, and Admiral Ackbar. So my team, what I'm thinking, it will be a good team for a Rebel team. Now there's two teams I'm thinking of. So you know, Ackbar at lead with Han for sure, Leia, and this is where, and HRS here. Now in this spot is kind of a wild card here, because, you know, I don't want Biggs and I don't want Luke, right? So here is where I'm probably gonna start off. If I run this team in arena, I would run GS, just because he's just so good all on his own, and with Han pulling aggro and those assists. If you're getting assists from Leia, you're possibly getting 3 shots from Leia. If you're getting assists from HRS, you're possibly refreshing his turn meter, and he's fast as is, you know what I mean? The other suggestion that I was thinking could be another team that could be really good would be to take out HRS here and put in Poggle. And what that'll do is that'll just give your team some great offensive up, some ability block utility. That would be pretty good team. You could take GS out, you know, and put in Poggle too. You leave HRS in if you want to do it that way. But that's kind of where I'm headed for my PvP team. Rock with the Rebels for a little bit. But yeah, that's kind of where I'm headed. The rest of it is all up in the air though. But my team usually for Galactic War, you know, we run just my strongest guys here, which would be that team right there. And then sometimes I'll take JC out and put JC or Luminar out and put Phasma, because Phasma is just a great utility character, giving the turn meter to the whole team, and she's pretty tanky. So I like that. Now this is gonna be, you know, super easy. So, as I take you guys through this, I should, you know, get a, you know, pretty good run. Like, sometimes this Galactic War is janky, though. Like, they'll just throw a whole squad of fully level 70s at me, like, on the second run. Like, I don't know, you know, what the developers are thinking when it comes to, you know, how they decide, you know, who you're playing against, but... I think they need to improve it a little bit, you know, because even if you have the highest, if you have the highest power you can in arena and it's based off arena, if you're fighting level 70s the whole way through, you're never going to make it with one team of level 70s. You would need multiple teams to do it. You know, you would need at least two full squads of 70, most likely, if you're playing all level 70s. To me, it's just it's crazy. You know, because I'm nowhere near that. I'm getting closer, but not even level 70 yet. But I am interested in this Rebel team just because it's, you know, the way the game is right now, it just seems like it's based so heavily off of, you know, speed. And the Rebels have a large amount of speed, and, you know, Akbar provides some pretty good utility and increases speed as well. And one of the cool things about Akbar is that move where he increases someone's random turn meter at 100%, which is really nice. You know, if you run him with a healer on the team, you know, like JC, you know, you bust, you're going to get heals constantly. Or whoever, you know, if you got GS constantly doing damage, it's just, it's super nice. But anyway, like, I've missed you guys. I've been wanting to make videos for so long, and I'm hoping that while doing this video, I'm able to complete it, because when my baby girl wants to eat, she wants to eat. You know, she don't play. But let's see here. So far so good. Pretty easy, you know. As you can see, the rewards are, you know, they're nice. They're very nice. All right, so we're starting to get a little stronger. Let's go back to squad arena. All right, so let's see if I can take the 28th spot here. Phasma teams are still pretty tough. You don't see too many of them anymore, but they give problems. You know, I mainly see Qui-Gon Jinn-led teams now. But Phasma is a beast. Well, at least she didn't... Barriss didn't get called in. That's a plus. I should be able to kill Dooku here. Ooh, close. So, I really don't want to lose GS, so we're just going to heal. Well, it was a good thing I healed, because I lost her anyway before I could do anything. Ooh, offense up. Things are looking up here. Oh, yeah, we got this. Oh, yeah. Just throw it on autoplay. So, you know, not bad. So now we're getting into... you know, this is where things get really hard for running the way I run, leaning more towards Galactic War, since I'm not heavily armed to deal with Arena and Galactic War at its maximum potential. Let's go ahead and grab some more of these Akbar and Stormtrooper Han nuggets. I'll come back to that here in a little bit. Alright, let's deal with this team. And I really do enjoy the Galactic War. I think the design of it is really cool, how you're able to use this entire roster, because they give you such a large roster. You should be able to use it. Gotta love that stupid music. Okay. So, things seem to be steadily rolling here, not too bad. Let's see who shall I beat first? We're gonna go with Lumi. Followed by Jawa. Followed by Eeth Koth. Oh, really, with the dodge? Should have been dead. And that's a wrap. Gotta say that I'm super happy that they put Qui-Gon Jinn in the Cantina shipments, because, he is my favorite Jedi out of all the Jedis out there. So I was working on him anyway, but they just made it to where I don't have to spend a dime to get him, which is great. There's actually nobody that I want that costs money at the moment, so the only person I wouldn't mind getting 7-star is Leia, because I'd like to keep her in my Rebel team. I may have to pull her out later if I can't get her to 7-star. Gotta say though, one character that looks really interesting to me is Rex. My guess is he's gonna be a pretty good character. Really interested to see just how good he is. I like his little like termina reduction things going on. Looks like it's gonna be pretty beast. So, things seem to be continuously decently easy. I'm not getting crazy level 70s yet. This is pretty much how it goes. I usually get one or two towards the end where I have to put multiple people in. So let's see here. With this, I'm probably gonna go for Luminara first. She's the main healer here. We're gonna get rid of her. Besides Jay Sizzle. This is where I may try and take out Sidious. I'm okay with that. Oh yeah, that offensive up is a big deal. Perfect. Luminara's heal should be ready on the next round. So that went fast. I like to try and get Luminara, right off the bat. She is a big threat, in my opinion. She's got decent speed too. All right, so you want to get rid of Ray. Ray is just. She's OP, in my opinion. She is very strong. Might have to go pick up my baby girl here. Let's see here. I'll be right back. I think I have to get my baby girl. Oh yeah, what's up guys? So I gotta feed my baby girl. So it's gonna be a minute. Let's see if I can finish this here. Take out Sauvage. You know, I'm really hoping that they increase the speed of some of these characters, because it seems like there's a lot of characters in this game that just, like, they look great, you know, but their speed is just terrible, like Ahsoka and Darth Maul, like, for example. Like, they just could be amazing characters, but their speed is so ass that, you know, it just makes you not want to play with them. You know, still going strong here. This is, you know, pretty general. Let's see here. I gotta return shortly. All right, back. Let's do this. Everything's going smooth. Baby's being fed. All right. Let's see here. Huh, this team looks annoying. We're going to go for... We're going to get Vader out of here. Of course, you want to get Luminara. But there's so many heals going on that team. Hello. Weird. I hate spam phone calls. Okay. So the strategy seems to still be working. You know, like, look at that. I only got three more, and, you know, still, you know, this team, like, I'll be able to beat this team no problem. So for those of you who are wondering, you know, if you're pursuing, you want to pursue the Galactic War and you're not a super duper whale, you know, that has all these characters, you know, it works. You know, as you can see, my power is at 23.6. I'm scared to go over 23.6 right now, because the higher your power, apparently, on your last arena win, you know, is determining the roles you get in Galactic War. So I'm not ready to go, because I like my Galactic War goodies. I mean, and I'm okay with getting, you know, this placing. So I don't think I can beat... We're going to try the 25 here, because this is where it really gets tough. So, but I know that, like, a lot of people, they're like, you know, Galactic War is too hard, and then, you know, you got Squad Arena, but with the way it's set up, if you try and play your cards right to where you don't go overboard on Squad Arena and get your power too high, you should be just fine. So the first thing we want to do is we do want to get rid of Qui-Gon Jinn. So we'll just kill Qui-Gon before he attacks. Get the offense up. Use Barriss's heal, which didn't really do much. And now we're gonna go for... We're just gonna go for Kylo Ren here, because he's already almost dead. Do some splash. I don't mind taking the counter from Dooku. Looks like I'll be able to kill him if I can get an assist. We're not going to want to attack Dooku with the Jedi. But I do want to attack him now with the assist. Perfect. Get Lumi. And this is it, guys. I mean, boom. As you can see, I mean... you know, with a level 48 blue-geared Barasafi, you know, I'm able to still... you know, compete in here with these guys. Pull a decent ranking. You know, there's not much in the arena shipments anyway, currently. The only thing that I'm getting is Admiral Akbar and Han Nuggets right now. I'm really not interested in Eeth Koth, because I'm not going to go that route to get Yoda. I'd rather have Barasafi and Mace Windu. You know, not too big on Mace Windu, but his expose is nice, and from what I've heard is it can be clutch in the Yoda challenge later on. So I guess, you know, is what it is. That's the way I'm going. Only thing I like about Eeth Koth is his speed, really. Other than that, he seems okay. I'm kind of mediocre. We're gonna, you know, I might be able to take this Sidious out right away. Seems kind of low on health. Very nice. Luminar is next. Okay, so... just do damage on him. If I can get an assist, yeah, I'll go for Dooku. Boom, just like that. One shot, no counter. Boom, fully healed, just like that. Okay, things are going pretty smooth here. Still pulling the lower level dudes. And I mean, you know, you're going to get a ton of gold. You know, you get so much gold doing this Galactic War. You know, good ability mats and training droids. That's why, you know, I'm scared to increase the power on my arena squad currently. Not too worried about this, just because... actually, this is kind of a... we got Poe over there. Maybe I can get an ability block with Lumi. Try and kill him before he gets exposed in. Perfect. Everything is going absolutely perfect. Boom. I should have healed with Lumi, but I didn't realize I was on super cooldown with JC. Oh man, this, you know what I'm saying? Usually I get a level 70 team here, but boom, I'll take it anytime. So let's do this. Alright, so it looks like I can one-hit Dooku on an assist. Oh, close. Dooku's not so bad. I mean, he's got low health, as long as you know that you can kill him right away, that's kind of where you want to go. And you don't want to attack him with your Jedi. That's why I like to mix. You know, I don't like to run all Jedi just because there's so much anti-Jedi. I mean, there's just everything is anti-Jedi, it seems like. So, you know, I try to make sure I don't attack my my Jedi with him. And I don't like to attack Sidious either with my Jedi, but sometimes I go for it with Qui-Gon's assist. But definitely on an assist with GS, you want to attack Sidious. How we roll. We just put on auto and let her go. Alright, and that's it. You know, end of the Galactic War. And I mean, you know, look at what you get. You know, you get some serious goodies along the way, you know. Now my gold is up there pretty good now. You know, I got plenty of stuff to go into Phasmin and into Poggle. You know, that's just how I roll. That's how I do things on this game in particular. I do want to climb the arena charts, but I don't want to kill myself in the Galactic War, so if you guys are out there, the viewers watching, you know, try this strategy. Try and stay below 23.5. That way you guys can continue through your Galactic Wars, because you're going to get a lot of your gold from there and a lot of your, you know, ability mats and droids, except for your challenges. And, of course, you're going to get plenty of tokens to use over there. As far as my plans go, I'll show you my roster real quick. So plan is, I kind of touched on it earlier, you know, finish my, you know, top four here, Lumi, Geo, Qui-Gon, Sidious, and Phasma. I'm going to finish those five first. When that's done and over with, my resources are going to be poured into Mace Windu, Jedi Counselor, Barriss Offee, then I'm going to get Yoda. Once, you know, that's all done, my next B team basically is going to be a Rebel team, which I would love to actually bring. Once I have that team, I would love to run that team as my arena team, just because I see so many of the same, you know, characters in there. I'd like to run a different team comp up in there, and then I should be able to, once I have all those characters built, I should be able to go for arena ranking and still complete Galactic War with several level 70s at that time. So anyway, guys, I hope this helps you, to the viewers out there. I'll be trying to make more videos if I can. It's really hard for me as I'm trying to take care of my baby at the same time. But anyway, guys, until next time, my name is Metzka. Have a good one.